the slopes or escaping to a tropical paradise, the holidays can be a busy time to travel. 83,000 passengers are expected to pass through Vancouver International Airport on Christmas Eve. And as a traveler, that means organization is key. Jane Stoller, author of Organizing Your Lifestyle, joins us now with five tips to make traveling in December a breeze. Good morning to you, Jane.
Hey, good morning.
Thanks for being here. So travel prep is vital.
Yeah, I say it's so important to start early because all of us are really good at overpacking. So start early and you won't be able to...
What's early?
Well, I say even 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Yeah.
Okay.
And going to my first tip is because we're so good at overpacking, I say keep a travel scale in your suitcase at all times. I brought two to show today. One's a digital, it's nice to have, but it needs batteries. And one doesn't need batteries at all. So if you keep these in your suitcase, you'll be able to weigh your bags because no one wants to be that person that can't carry their own suitcase or has to repack their bags in the line. It's just, it's not cool.
And it's 22 pounds, right?
So for a carry-on, you need, it's the max is rule of thumb 22 pounds. And for a check bag, rule of thumb is 50 pounds, but check with your airline.
Okay. And there are things that you could leave at home, live without.
Yeah, there are definitely things you could leave at home, and that's usually after trips I make notes about what I didn't wear or what I didn't use, so next time I will leave that at home.
Okay, let's talk toiletries, because obviously you need toiletries when you travel. What did you bring in here?
Yeah, I just always have this in my suitcase ready to go, so when I pack, I don't even go to my bathroom. This just stays in my suitcase. It's TSA approved. You can get this for under $10 at Sephora. Keeps all your liquids. If something spills, you can easily replace it. It's not an expensive item, but it's good to have ready and packed and to go.
And transparent, too.
Exactly.
All right, so before we head to the airport, it's good to check in online, obviously. That saves some time.
Yeah, check in online. And also, I say have a travel wallet. It's also pre-packed. I keep this one that I've had for over 10 years now, and it's nicely labeled with, you know, passport, your boarding passes if you still carry them, and your currency, because you don't need all of the stuff that if you're going internationally, you don't need your home currency, you don't need your cards from Save on Foods, whatever it may be. So keep what you need in your travel wallet as well and have that pre-packed.
That's 10 years old. That looks brand new.
This is 10 years old.
That's crazy.
Don't zoom in.
Okay, what is this?
We're at the airport. We've checked in with our nice travel wallet. And now, especially in Canada, we're going sometimes from a cold destination to a warm destination or even from Vancouver to Toronto, and when we get there, it's freezing. Mm-hmm. So having a jacket that's foldable, I love, because this actually expands to a full-size puffy jacket.
Okay.
There's lots on the market, but... Also, overhead compartments are, you know, not in airplanes, and especially during the holiday season, are full. So,
yeah. You
know, wear this to the airport, pack it up, and then take it out when you need it.
And that's just not a rain repellent. This is actually a
It's a full jacket, puffy jacket. And there's lots of different brands out there, but and they don't even wrinkle when you take them out. They're amazing.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Your organizer.
Yeah, so I always bring this notebook. I always carry a notebook wherever I go. This one's branded with my brand Organized Jane for organizedjane.com. But after a trip, I always say make notes about what worked well, what you didn't wear, what you can leave behind next time so you're not stressed about packing for that next trip.
Okay. When you get to your destination, I was asking you about this before we started, trying to figure out what it was, but then finally.
So this was actually featured in Air Canada's En Route magazine last year. And a good friend of mine who's a frequent traveler got me onto this, and I never leave it. It's in my suitcase now. I never leave home without it. It is a travel clothesline, so you can attach it to doorknobs. You can attach it to even in showers, and you can stick clothes in through the holes here. And the beauty of it is, especially during holiday travel, we're staying at in-laws or we're staying places that don't have closet space. So hang this up, and it'll be a lifesaver.
Okay, speaking of in-laws.
Yes.
Aromatic. So
I don't always carry candles with me when I travel, but for holiday season, it's a great idea to take a candle with you if you're stuck in an airport that, you know, because of a delay or in-laws, whatever it may be. But it just makes travel a little bit nicer. And this one also doubles as lotion as well. So it's by the Urban Undercover. So it's a great little two-in-one.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. Finally, just to recap, the best tip for travelers during the holiday season, it seems to me, is just be prepared for anything, right?
Yes. And, you know, we prepared pre-travel, but during travel, I say have at least 5 hours, like have a contingency plan of things that you would love to do, being productive or maybe movies you wanted to watch, have books downloaded on your, you know, on your Kindle ready to read. So when you're delayed, it's not that big of a deal.
Okay. If you like reading, you could always check out your book, right?
Exactly. You can buy that for the holiday season. So it's Organizing for Your Lifestyle. I'm writing a second book as well. It should be out in 2019.
So. Awesome stuff. Thank you so much, Jane, for your tips.
Yes, thank you.
Happy holidays. If you want to watch the segment again, you can go to our website, CTV morninglive.ca.